Hello, I'm John, an engineer on the Core Media Spatial Technologies team. In this video, I will go over the fundamentals of how non-rectilinear video projection is represented in QuickTime files. Also, I will present updates we've introduced to Core Media, Video Toolbox, and AV Foundation frameworks for reading, writing, editing, and publishing Apple Projected Media Profile, or APMP, video. And finally, I will cover using the Apple Positional Audio Codec to add immersive spatial audio to projected video media. Whether you are a camera vendor offering a 180 or 360 degree or wide field of view camera, a developer of video editing software, or an app developer wanting to work with an exciting new type of media, this video will have something for you. I recommend watching Explore Video Experiences for VisionOS for important introductory information about the immersive video profiles available on VisionOS 26 and the concept of video projections. I'll start with a review of the non-rectilinear video fundamentals introduced in the Explore Video Experiences for VisionOS video. New for VisionOS 26 is the Apple Projected Media Profile, which can support 180, 360, and wide FOV video from consumer-accessible cameras. A key differentiator within the projected media profile is the projection kind. 2D, 3D, and spatial video use a rectilinear projection. 180-degree video uses a half-equirectangular projection, 360-degree video uses equirectangular, and wide FOV video uses a parametric projection. The equirectangular projection, also known as the equidistant cylindrical projection, is widely supported by editing applications, such as Final Cut Pro. In the equirectangular projection, the pixel coordinates of an enclosing sphere are expressed as angles of latitude and longitude and projected equally into the rows and columns of a rectangular video frame. The horizontal axis maps longitude from negative to positive 180 degrees, while the vertical axis maps latitude from negative to positive 90 degrees. The half-equirectangular projection is similar, but the x-coordinate within the video frame represents the range from negative 90 to positive 90 degrees. The parametric immersive projection represents the intrinsics and lens distortion parameters associated with wide-angle or fisheye lenses. Intrinsics represent information such as the focal length, an optical center, and the skew of the lens system used for capture. These parameters are interpreted as a 3x3 matrix, denoted as K for camera matrix, that represents a transformation from 3D world coordinates to 2D coordinates on an image plane. In addition, the parametric immersive projection can represent lens distortion parameters, for example, radial distortion. Radial distortion parameters are used to correct for barrel distortion, where straight lines appear curved proportionally to their distance from the optical center due to wide-angle lens design. In this image, the fence posts appear curved towards the edge of the lens. Other lens distortion characteristics, such as tangential distortion, projection offset, radial angle limit, and lens frame adjustments, can be specified in the parametric immersive projection as well. Now that I've covered the fundamentals, I'll provide an overview of how to use Apple's APIs to interact with Apple Projected Media Profile content. I'll start by describing how APMP video is carried in QuickTime and MP4 movie files. Apple Projected Media Profile enables signaling of 180, 360, and wide FOV in QuickTime and MP4 files. QuickTime files are structured as a hierarchy of containers of various types of media data, and can include audio and video tracks, as well as data describing the details of each track. The ISO-based media file format, or ISO-BMFF specification for MP4, was adapted from QuickTime. The fundamental unit of data organization in an ISO-BMFF file is a box. For VisionOS 1, we introduced a new video extended usage extension box with stereo view information, indicating stereoscopic or monoscopic content. For VisionOS 26, we add new boxes to video extended usage, also known as VexView, to enable signaling of the projected media profile. The projection box signals one of the projection types, such as equirectangular, half-equirectangular, or parametric immersive. A lens collection box contains the parameters for intrinsics, extrinsics, and lens distortions for the parametric immersive projection. The view packing box contains information about the arrangement of eyes in a frame-packed image, whether side-by-side or over-under. Here's an example of the minimal signaling for a monoscopic equirectangular file. The projection box with projection kind indicating equirectangular. A stereoscopic 180-degree file requires a stereo view box in addition to the projection kind signaling half equirectangular. With these building blocks, it is also possible to signal other combinations, such as stereoscopic 360. Check out the QuickTime and ISO-based media file formats and spatial and immersive media specification on developer.apple.com for more information on the projection box and other boxes supported by Apple Projected Media Profile. Next, I'll outline some ways to capture APMP content, as well as typical APMP workflows. There are a variety of cameras available to capture APMP-compatible content. For example, Canon's EOS VR system to capture and process stereoscopic 180 video, GoPro Max or Insta360 X5 for 360 video, and recent action cameras like the GoPro Hero 13 and Insta360 Ace Pro 2 for wide FOV video. Final Cut Pro already supports reading and writing APMP for 360-degree formats, and, coming later this year, camera video editing software such as Canon's EOS VR utility and the GoPro Player support exporting of MOV or MP4 files with Apple Projected Media Profile signaling. For 180 or 360 video, use camera vendor software for operations such as stitching, stabilization, and stereo image correction. If the editor is already APMP enabled, export as an MOV or MP4 file with APMP signaling included. Finally, AirDrop or use iCloud to transfer files to Apple Vision Pro. Otherwise, if your camera software does not yet support Apple Projected Media, you can export as 180 or 360 using spherical metadata. Then, use the AV Convert macOS utility, either from the command line or through a Finder action by control-clicking a selection of one or more video files. Finally, AirDrop or use iCloud to transfer files to Apple Vision Pro. Apple Projected Media Profile is suitable for signaling projected video through full media workflows, including capture, editing, and delivery. Here is an example of stereoscopic 180 workflow where APMP signaling can be used at each step. Capture the content using HEVC, RAW, or ProRes codecs. Then edit using ProRes. For capturing and editing 3D content, you can utilize frame-packed, multi-view, separate movie files per eye, and even two video tracks signaled in one movie file. In this example, capture requires two movie files, while editing is performed with side-by-side frame-packed content. Encode and publish using the multi-view HEVC or MV-HEVC codec for efficient delivery and playback on Vision OS. Now that I have covered the APMP specification and typical workflows, I'll review the new capabilities available in macOS and Vision OS 26 for working with APMP files using existing media APIs. I'll start with asset conversion capabilities. Developers of media workflow-related apps will need time to adopt APMP signaling, so we've added functionality in AV Foundation to recognize compatible assets that use spherical metadata V1 or V2 signaling. Compatible 180 or 360 content has an equirectangular projection and can be frame-packed stereo or monoscopic. Pass the asset creation option should parse external spherical tags to recognize directly compatible spherical content and synthesize the appropriate format description extensions. This will allow other system APIs to treat the asset as if it were signaled with Apple Projected Media Profile. Check for the presence of the format description extension converted from external spherical tags to determine whether spherical metadata was parsed. Vision OS 26 has built-in support for lens projection parameters and popular field of view modes for camera vendors such as GoPro and Insta360. Quick Look prompts to convert such files upon opening. To enable wide FOV content conversion in your applications, use the Parametric Immersive Asset Info object from the Immersive Media Support Framework. it generates a video format description that contains a parametric immersive projection with intrinsics and lens distortion parameters for compatible camera models. Use the isConvertible property to determine if metadata from a compatible camera was detected, and replace the video track's format description with the newly derived format description. Now, system APIs that use this asset will recognize the content as Wide FoV APMP. Please refer to the Converting Projected Video to Apple Projected Media Profile sample application to learn how to convert into delivery-ready APMP formats. You can read APMP video using familiar system media APIs. Core Media and AV Foundation frameworks have been updated to support projected media identification and reading. If you need to identify an asset as conforming to an APMP profile, perhaps for the purpose of badging or preparing a specific playback experience, you can use AV Asset Playback Assistant and look for the non-rectilinear projection configuration option. To learn about building APMP video playback experiences, check out the Support Immersive Video Playback in VisionOS Apps video. When you need more detail, first examine media characteristics to determine if the video track indicates a non-rectilinear projection. Then, you can examine the projection kind to determine the exact projection signaled. The View Packing Kind format description extension identifies frame-packed content. It supports side-by-side and over-under frame packing. To edit projected media, use the AV Video Composition object from the AV Foundation framework and become familiar with CM-tagged buffers. CM-tagged dynamic buffers are used across multiple APIs to handle stereoscopic content, including editing APIs such as AV Video Composition. CM-tagged dynamic buffer provides a way to specify certain properties of underlying buffers, denoted as CM tags. Each CM tag will contain a category and value. Here is an example CM tag representing a stereo view category indicating the left eye. CM tagged dynamic buffers may be grouped into related buffers, such as in this example, showing CV pixel buffers for left and right eyes in a stereoscopic video sample. To enable stereoscopic video editing with AV Video Composition, we have added API for specifying the format of tagged buffers produced by a compositor and a method to pass tagged buffers to composition requests. The output buffer description specifies what type of CM tagged buffers the compositor will be producing. Define it before starting composition. After constructing a stereoscopic pair of CM tagged buffers, call finish and pass the tagged buffers. Now that I've described how to convert, read, and edit Apple Projected Media Profile assets, I'll talk about the process of writing them. In this code example for writing monoscopic 360 video, I am using AV Asset Writer to create the asset. I'm using the compression property key projection kind to specify the equirectangular projection kind. Compression properties are passed to AV Asset Writer input using the output settings dictionary property AV Video Compression Properties key. Next, I'll provide recommendations for APMP content publishing. These are recommended limits for playback on VisionOS. The video codec encoding parameters should conform to HEVC main or main 10 with 420 chroma subsampling. Rec 709 or P3D65 color primaries are recommended. Stereo mode may be monoscopic or stereoscopic. The suggested resolution at 10 bits for monoscopic is 7680 by 3840, 4320 by 4320 per eye for stereoscopic. Frame rates vary by resolution and bit depth, with 30 frames per second recommended for 10-bit monoscopic 8K or stereoscopic 4K. Bitrate encoding settings are content dependent and should be chosen appropriately for your use case, but we recommend not exceeding 150 megabits per second peak. Additional information about the MVHEVC stereo video profile used by Apple is available in the document Apple HEVC Stereo Video Interoperability Profile on developer.apple.com. We have updated the Advanced Video Quality Tool, or AVQT, to support immersive formats such as 3D, spatial, and APMP 180 and 360 content, along with algorithmic enhancements for better accuracy. AVQT is useful for assessing the perceptual quality of compressed video content and fine-tuning video encoder parameters. It is also helpful for HLS tier bitrate optimization. New features include the ability to calculate quality metrics using awareness of the equirectangular and half-equirectangular projections. The HTTP live streaming specification has been enhanced with support for streaming Apple projected media profile. And the latest HLS tools available on the Apple developer website have been updated to support publishing APMP. This is an example manifest for a stereoscopic 180 asset. The key change is in the EXT Extreme Information tag. The Rec Video Layout attribute is specifying stereo and half equirectangular projection. Note that the map segment must also contain a format description extension signaling the half equirectangular projection and stereo view information. For the latest information on HLS bitrate tier ladders and other HLS authoring guidelines, see the HLS authoring specification on the Apple developer website. Spatial audio is as important as video when creating a compelling immersive experience. In the real world, sound can come from anywhere. To recreate this experience, a technology capable of representing the entire sound field is required. We designed the Apple Positional Audio Codec, or APAC, for this purpose. One important capability of APAC is encoding ambisonic audio in order to capture a high-fidelity representation of the sound field. Ambisonic audio is a technique for recording, mixing, and playing back full-sphere spatial audio. Ambisonic recordings are not tied to a specific speaker layout, as the sound field is encoded mathematically using a set of spherical harmonic basis functions. Ambisonic audio capture uses an array of microphones arranged to take a recording of the 3D sound environment. And then, using digital signal processing, the microphone signals are transformed into signals with directionality corresponding to spherical harmonic components. The combination of all these signals is an accurate representation of the original sound field. The term order in ambisonics refers to the number of spherical components used to represent an audio mix. First order is four components, or channels, and correspond to one omnidirectional channel and three channels representing front-back, left-right, and up-down directionally oriented audio. Second order ambisonics uses nine components, while third order ambisonics use 16. The higher order ambisonics provide more spatial resolution. Apple Positional Audio Codec is a high-efficiency spatial audio codec and is recommended for encoding spatial audio, including ambisonics, with APMP video. APAC decodes on all Apple platforms except for watchOS. The built-in APAC encoder, accessible via AV Asset Writer on iOS, macOS, and visionOS platforms, supports first, second, and third-order ambisonics. This code shows the minimal output settings required to encode first, second, or third order ambisonics using AV Asset Writer. Recommended bit rates for ambisonics encoded to APAC for APMP range from 384 kilobits per second for first order to 768 kilobits per second for third order. APAC audio can be segmented and streamed via HLS. Here's an example of a monoscopic equirectangular video with APAC audio encoding a third-order ambisonic track. Now that you've learned about Apple projected media profile, add support for APMP in your app or service to enable immersive user-generated content, playback, editing, and sharing. If you are a camera vendor, integrate APMP where appropriate to unlock playback in the Apple ecosystem. Adopt Apple Positional Audio Codec to deliver an immersive audio sound field from an ambisonic microphone capture together with your immersive video. Thanks for watching. Now I'm going to go capture some stereoscopic 180 video.